Hi all, welcome to PowerShell for Penetration Testers at Pentester Academy. In this video, let's have a look at how to execute commandlets on remote computers. For few upcoming videos, we will move on from our local machine onto the remote computers and we'll see in detail about PowerShell remoting and related things. So in this video, first of all, let's explore commandlets with computer name parameter. We will focus on those commandlets which accept the computer name parameter, accept the credential parameter, and do not require PowerShell remoting to be configured on a remote machine. So, first of all, do not forget this. There are a lot of help files on PowerShell remoting. Read those. Then let's move to our trusted get command. Let's list commandlets which accept the computer name parameter. So all these commandlets accept the computer name parameter. Now, how do we know or how do we list those commandlets which also accept the credential parameter? For example, the get process commandlet accepts the computer name parameter but not the credential parameter. As you can see, it threw an error because it could not find a credential parameter. Domain PC is my VM and Bharat is my local domain. So let's use PowerShell filtering. Let's again list all the commandlets and let's use where object to filter out the not required ones. This special symbol, if we have not came across it earlier, it is the this value or it holds the current value in a pipeline or script block. For example, here this thing dollar underscore dot holds value coming from this expression. So let's filter out those commandlets which accept the computer name parameter. Nice. Now we just need to keep adding the conditions we want. We want that the commandlet should also accept the credential parameter. Good. But it should not contain the session parameter, which means it supports the PowerShell remoting. So these are the commandlets which we can use for this current video. Now get hotfix sometimes take much time, so let's execute it in a separate PowerShell session and come back to it whenever it is complete. So let's use get hotfix computer name, my local machine, credential, now meanwhile it gets executed. Let's see what we, how do we see this thing. Whenever we use things like this, we can pass these to the getMember commandlet for different members. We will come back to the getMember in detail later on, but for now you can use these to list different members of a commandlet or command. Meanwhile, here it has been executed, and there is much detail about the patches installed on that local machine. So here we executed get hotfix on a single machine. Let's use a faster one. Let's use test connection and how do we execute a commandlet on multiple machines? This was used to execute it on a single machine. If you can recall, we saw a very useful loop called for each. Let's use for each here. Let's try on all these things and run test connection on each one by one. As you can see, the commandlet is being executed on each and every one of these machines. We can always use a list of machines here with get content, because get content reads a file line by line. We can have a new line separated list of servers. Now, a quick exercise. You may like to set up a Windows 7 VM, or if you have a separate machine, for that machine, use get hotfix with both of these parameters and check for the presence of the pass the hash fix. Should be very easy. That is all for this video. If you are enjoying your time at Pentester Academy, please recommend us to your friends and colleagues.